Fox body is no longer at Spencer's. In fact, during the recording of this video, the Fox body wasn't at our place either, because somebody fucking stole it. That's right, some ass fuck stole our car. They stole our car. I owed a blood debt to Spencer, so I went over to help him with his shitty BMW, which is currently out of commission. At the mercy of my equally unreliable 2015 Mustang, I headed to Spencer's to help him disembowel the E46.
Dude, I'm telling you.
I'm telling you.
Go here. Oh. You got a Supra.
I have a Supra.
It is a mosquito. You want to get schmacked?
Schmacked! It was all fun and games until one of Spencer's neighbors came around asking if we had seen his pet mosquito, Mr. Nibbles.
Howdy.
Hey, how you doing?
Pretty good.
We played it off perfectly. He didn't suspect a thing.
Oh, I just forgot. We could be playing music, so that's like less depressing here.
Well, what do you want to play?
What the fuck, really? Yeah.
It's got me feeling like I'm on the run. Having so much fun.
Thanks, Spencer. My new hydro has a condom on it now, thanks to you. May Bloody Nose curse your whole family line.
Fuck, I'm so sorry.
All of it. All of your bloodline.
Yeah, I can't reach that.
I can help.
Bruh.
Who are you with the cabinet?
I don't know. I just shit my pants.
Looks like the neighbor sent one of his other cretins over. This guy seems like he's sniffing around for his blood-sucking brother. This wasn't good. We had to get rid of him, and fast.
We good?
This happy-looking dog spy was persistent. I think he's on to us.
I'm gonna try going from the front again, because that might actually have been
I'm just concerned about the rear, dude. It's like so toward the middle.
Dude, I'm just concerned about your mom last night. We were backing up.
Do you wanna film this, Jacob? This bullshit?
No, Spencer, I really don't.
So, whatever happened at the jack point from the previous owner, Cris, is now completely missing. So we are replacing that jack point with a piece of petrified wood. And on the other side, we're also just normal jack, just sitting there. But this side gets wood. Just like your mother got my wood last night.
Oh, dude. Dude, nice cock.
Sick.
Thanks.
Let's see what happens.
Oh, wait. Did you see that? Look, the car moves independent of the side skirt.
Yeah, this is active aero.
Do I have faith in this? Not in the slightest, but like, it's not going anywhere. We can just, let's just shake the car.
Like, it's gonna keep the car alive if it falls.
It's fine. Are we like taking this door apart?
I want it off.
How do you expect that to happen with this giant post here is beyond me.
So take the post off?
It looks like the neighbor sent over another one of his pawns to drop off a package. I can only assume it's a bomb. Nevertheless, I was polite to the gentleman.
Thank you.
As my mama always used to pray, go away, the package always has to stay.
You wanna take the trim off too?
What is that?
You wanna take the trim off in the end of it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna reuse this, right?
No.
90 degrees to the left.
You wanna do a dipstick
to leave?
Smells like shit. Oh, what? There's like a mosquito in here. Give me a little piece of shit.
Tim has undone all of my diplomacy. Things just went from bad to worse. Did you see Alex try to murder me with that hood? Oh my god, I should have known Alex was working for the man next door this whole time.
I'm helped.
Wow, between almost killing me and the secretive phone calls, I think it's safe to say Alex is in fact an inside agent for the troublesome neighbor.
That was the IRS being audited.
Yikes. Good luck with that one, bud. I honestly even kind of feel a little bit bad for the guy. Maybe. But I don't know.
Let me get out of the way.
Jesus.
I'm just gonna rip the door in half.
Perfect condition. Door. If you need one, contact Spencer.
Fuck BMW, dude.
I agree.
What is the purpose? This shit. I'm fucked.
That's twice now. Alex is definitely a double agent.
Oh yeah, that's awesome. Okay, cool.
You guys might want this. Really help.
You don't mind the paint getting a little power steering fluid on it, right?
No, of course not.
Did it just break?
It just fucking disintegrated.
We broke the quick disconnect fittings on it. So instead of doing the smart thing and trying to pull them out from the other side, we are just going to cut them.
We can't take off the fenders because I don't know where my Torx bits are. We didn't do that today. But for the interior is pretty much stripped now. Thank you, both of you guys, for doing that. So we can cross that off. We still have to pull the bed dash. Still have to pull the subframe, the rear subframe. That's still a decent amount of work. Entire front end, starting to look a lot easier to pull the motor. I think next stuff is going to be pull front harness. And then the second bit is going to be pull fuel. Yeah, looking good.
Cool.
Thank you.
It's almost like an aerial.
Oh, right. The joke is that this is the poor man's aerial.
Hey, did you ever want an aerial, Adam, but you were like, I don't have $100,000?
Buy a Mazda Miata and then just get rid of everything else.
So they literally just take a Mazda Miata, rip the entire body off of it, and then you buy this chassis and you basically, short version, drop the chassis on. And then at this point, it's getting everything functioning well. And then the shitty part comes when you're done and you're like, I built it. Now you gotta take it all apart so you can get this powder coated. I imagine I cannot remember. Man, it's turning me on right now. All my sadness, what I need for shelter.